You are now listening to the homily of Father John McGowan, OCD, priest and member of the Discalced Carmelites Order in the UK. This service is provided by the Lectio Divina team, part of the LOV Verbum Dei ministry, who invites you all to share this reflection and their love for the Word of God. The Gospel is the good news of salvation for mankind. That salvation is only through Jesus Christ, as Peter said, "Lord, to whom shall we go? You alone have the words of eternal life."
Greetings to all who are listening, including the Love Verbum Dei family and also the Logical Bible Study Ministry.
It is by exploring the Word of Christ that we root ourselves in Him, deepen our relationship with Him, and see His presence in our life. We also want to let you know that there is a group of LOV members who are going through the Catechism using the Catechism in Ear podcast from Father Mike Skims on WhatsApp. So if you want to join the group and being part of a community to read the Catechism in an interactive and fun way and supported spiritually by others, click on the link in the description to join our community. Now, let's read the Gospel according to Matthew, chapter 17, verse 1 to 9, in preparation of today's homily. Jesus took with him Peter and James and his brother John, and led them up a high mountain where they could be alone. There in the presence he was transfigured. His face shone like the sun, and his clothes became as white as the light. Suddenly Moses and Elijah appeared to them. They were talking with him. Then Peter spoke to Jesus. "Lord," he said, "it is wonderful for us to be here. If you wish, I will make three tents here, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." He was still speaking when suddenly a bright cloud covered them with shadow, and from the cloud there came a voice which said, "This is my son, the beloved. He enjoys my favor. Listen to him." When they heard this, the disciples fell on their faces, overcome with fear. But Jesus came up and touched them. "Stand up," he said. "Do not be afraid." And when they raised their eyes, they saw no one but only Jesus. As they came down from the mountain, Jesus gave them this order: "Tell no one about the vision until the Son of Man has risen from the dead." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
One of the things I find fascinating about reading Scripture is that no matter how familiar it is, there is always something new, something I hadn't noticed before. Today's Gospel was no exception. I must have read this Gospel of the Transfiguration hundreds of times over the years. But as I sat down to prepare this homily and read it again, something new jumped out. Peter tells Jesus that it is wonderful to be there, and suggests to Jesus that he build three tents, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah. But what about himself? Why wouldn't he build a tent for himself? This is what struck me, the significance of which I'd never noticed before. So I asked, why wouldn't Peter build a tent for himself too? Now, I don't know the answer, and I may be reading too much into it, but could it be that Peter didn't feel important enough? Here on this mountain was Jesus, the Son of God, the Messiah, as well as Moses, the one to whom God gave the Ten Commandments, the law. And there too was Elijah, the great Old Testament prophet. Three huge figures. Is it any wonder Peter felt so small, so insignificant? He was just an ordinary, simple fisherman from a tiny town most people hadn't heard of, uneducated and, in his own eyes, unimportant. Why Jesus would want to have anything to do with him, he could not understand. Why he chose him and two others to go up the mountain, again, he didn't understand. He saw things on the mountain that no human being had seen before, things so bizarre, so fantastic, that he could hardly believe what he was seeing. Once again, he asked himself, why me? Who am I? But Jesus hadn't taken Peter and the others up the mountain for exercise. He took them up to teach them something that they would never forget. His transfiguration showed them for the first time who he really was, the inner mystery of his being. Peter had first met Jesus in his hometown of Capernaum, where Jesus had come to live. Peter knew him as a fellow human being. He obviously was deeply inspired by him when he saw and heard the miracles, the healing, and the words of wisdom. But now, for the first time, he saw Jesus in a new light, literally. What Jesus wanted to teach Peter and the others is that they too were special. Indeed, they too would become like him. All that happened 2,000 years ago. Today, when we think of Peter, we think of someone special, someone in whom God has done great things. He is no longer ordinary, a mere fisherman from Galilee. We venerate him as a saint. It was because he listened to Jesus' words, as that voice from the cloud told him to, that he became not ordinary, but extraordinary. But the wonderful truth I have come to realize is that we are all called to be extraordinary. I can hear you say, but who am I? I'm so ordinary, so unimportant. Why should God want to do great things in me? Why is a good question, but don't ask, just believe. God wants to transform all of us into images of his Son. We don't need to go up a mountain or go into the desert. Just listen every day to what Jesus tells us in Scripture, and God will do the rest. And may Almighty God bless you, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
The Lectio Divina team hopes that this homily has helped you to deeply welcome the Word of God and gave you the strength to put the Word into practice where you are. You can send us your prayer intentions by emailing them to us using the following email address: love_verbumdei@outlook.com. All these prayer intentions will be prayed for in our daily Angelus group, call on WhatsApp, and also during our different weekly prayer groups gathering, both in person and online. Check our website in the description for days and times. If this homily has enlightened you or touched you in any way, please share it with your relatives, friends, community, and on your social media. Have a blessed week.